Unreal Engineering, how China builds space station in 2 years, the ISS versus China Tiangong. For most of its lifetime, the International Space Station, or ISS, has been used solely by government partners, with the United States at the head of the table, along with partner nations Russia, Europe, Japan, and Canada. 19 other nations have participated in specific projects along the way. However, Russia could be looking to break away from the ISS with sanctions related to the Ukraine war biting Russia's economy. On the other hand, China was effectively shut out from the ISS after Congress passed a law in 2011 banning NASA from collaborating in any way with China in response to human rights abuses in China, as well as the theft of intellectual property, and is also part of a broader geopolitical rivalry between China and the US. So, what does China do? Built its own space station. International Space Station, or ISS, versus Tiangong. Two space stations are competing to influence the scientific and political future of near-Earth space. The International Space Station is the veteran with history and experience and the backing of the global scientific community. Its new challenger is Tiangong, China's smaller but newer space station. Let's compare the two stations, size and crew members. The Chinese space station will be lighter than the ISS. It will be about 80 to 100 tons in weight, with only 3 modules, compared with ISS weighing about 400 tons attached with 16 modules. That's roughly 1/5 the mass of the ISS. The ISS has supported as many as 13 crew members on board, whereas the Tiangong is currently equipped to handle 3. Modules. The Chinese space station is currently set to have 3 modules. The Tianhe core module with 2 lab modules, where the ISS has a substantial 16 modules. The ISS is made up of 5 Russian modules, 8 US modules, 2 Japanese modules, and 1 European module. While it took 30 missions over a decade to get the ISS up and running, China intends to complete Tiangong in just 2 years. The main Tianhe living space was launched in April 2021, and the remaining 2 lab modules will join and be fully operational by the end of 2022. China has already sent its first crew members to the still-under-construction station and is expected to be the only country to operate its own space station. Structure. The Tiangong space station is constructed around the Tianhe core module. This section is the main one and provides life support and living quarters for the 3 crew members, as well as guidance, navigation, and orientation control for the station. This is also where the station's power, propulsion, and life support systems are kept. It boasts 3 sections: living quarters, a service section, and a docking hub. The ISS, on the other hand, is divided into 2 sections. There's a Russian orbital segment, or ROS, that is operated by Russia, and the United States orbital segment, USOS, that is run by the United States, together with a number of other nations. Each has its own living quarters, as well as science laboratories. Power supply. Both the ISS and Tiangong use solar power to sustain themselves. The ISS's electrical system uses photovoltaics, where solar cells directly convert sunlight to electricity. Meanwhile, Tiangong uses 2 steerable solar power arrays located on each module. These make use of gallium arsenide photovoltaic cells to convert sunlight into electricity. These 2 methods might sound very similar, but they do have important differences. The main one is that Tiangong uses solar arrays, whereas the ISS uses wings. These solar array wings consist of 2 retractable blankets of solar cells. Robotic arms. The ISS boasts very useful and efficient robotic arms that are not present in the Chinese space station. Robotic arms are mounted outside the space station. The robot arms were used to build the space station. Those arms can also move astronauts around when they go on spacewalks outside. Experiments. Considering the ISS has been around for over 2 decades, it's not fair to compare the experiments of the 2 stations, but it should be noted that the Tiangong has an ambitious experimental schedule planned. The new space station will be equipped to hold more than 20 experimental racks with enclosed pressurized environments, and more than 1,000 experiments have been approved by CMSA. While Tiangong is no match for the size, research capabilities, and astronaut living capacity for now, it is interesting to see if it will slowly grow and be as big and productive as the ISS.
But in the future, you know that maybe after operation for several years, maybe for 10 years, we can launch another core module, or secondary core module, this one, to the station. And with this module, you can see we can have more docking ports and berthing ports to the station.